Hi everyone, so we are here today doing my monthly June flips and flops. So I'm ready. I have about 13 items total. I am using my new, Olay BB cream that I got in my influencer box with just a little bit of powder over it. Nothing extravagant, and I really love this look. It's perfect for a day like today where I plan on being outside for most of the day. So, thumbs up if you want a walkthrough of this look. Super simple and easy. Alright, so let's get started with our June flips and flaps. So, my first flip, one of my favorite things, I've used this every day almost, I think, except weekends, is this Olay Total 7 Effects CC Cream. When I first introduced this and did a review of it, I mentioned that I could probably use this for a month. Well, I've been using it for a couple of weeks now, and this is all of the product that I have used. I use this every single day. I go to work under my makeup as my primer, and I love this formula. My face, my skin feels renewed. It feels like it is being regenerated. It has the SPF 15. I really absolutely love this product, and for $22, I think it was, I paid, it was really, really worth it for me. So if you have the chance to give this a try, please do try it, because it is a really great product. And I do have combination skin. I don't feel that it makes my skin any extra oily, but that's how it works for me. All right, one of the flops for this month is the CoverGirl CG Smoothers BB Cream. I had really, really, really high hopes for this. I wanted it forever. Every time I would go to the store to buy it, it was out. I think I just expected it to be a lot thicker. Maybe I wanted it to be thicker, but it seems like pretty decent when you first pump it out, but then as you rub it in, it's super thin. Like, it's even thinner than my regular facial lotions, so it didn't really give me any coverage. I understand that it is a tinted moisturizer, but it didn't even do anything. It's very, very, very sheer. So this is good. I would honestly use this as a face sunblock if I was at the beach. That's what I would use it for, because it does have SPF 15. Very, very, very sheer. Little too sheer for what I wanted. All right, another product that I absolutely love this month is the e.l.f. Daily Moisture Stick. I love this little doodad. I think he was $6 at Target. It is just a stick of moisturizer, and basically anytime you feel that your face needs a little lift, I especially use this underneath my eyes, like when I get home from work and say I'm going to touch up to go somewhere else, I would just give it a swipe under my eyes and then reapply my concealer. So I really do like this. I have used this all over my face. It isn't the smoothest to put all over your face, so I kind of just like do it sporadically and then rub it in, but this does have antioxidants and anti-aging ingredients: grape, cocoa, shea, avocado, macadamia, aloe, and chamomile. So for $6, this is a really good pick-me-up, especially if you get dry spots during the day. You can just, you know, even rub your finger on it and just fix your under eye makeup, maybe if it creases. All right, my next flop, and I only have three of them this month, so my next flop was a major flop. I've always, clearly, I mean, I don't have anything on my eyebrows today because I didn't feel they needed to be specially done, but I have always done my own eyebrows, and if you do follow my channel, you know that I have not done anything to my eyebrows in almost a year. They do not grow because they were waxed so often when I was younger. I worked at a hair salon. I got them waxed every week. They do not grow. So I wish that was the case for the stupid hairs on my upper lip, but those still come back. I wish we could move them up here. But I had a, I think it's the, it was a professional wax brand. I don't remember. I bought it at Sally Beauty Supply, but it was microwavable. But I had it for a really long time and I'm like, well, let me try something new. So I happened to buy the Sally Hansen All Over Body Wax Kit at TJ Maxx for $3.99. And it said you could use it all over your face, anywhere. It was for everything. And it had, was it argan oil? It was like some special Brazilian formula, passion flower, safflower oil, and orange oil, and orchid. Okay, don't use it for your face. The wax was too soft. If you know anything about getting waxed, you have obviously a liquid wax. When you put it onto the skin, you cover it with the muslin strip, right? And the waxer always pushes the muslin strip because you're hardening the wax underneath. And it's always when the muslin strip is tacky to touch on the outside is when you're ready to rip it off. That's how you wax. I was a waxer at a salon for quite a few years. I did tons of eyebrows, bodies, faces, etc. So you just really want to make sure it's tacky on the outside of the muslin strip and then you rip it off. This one, I'm rubbing. It felt tacky and when I ripped it, it was too smooth. Like it never got hard enough to grab the hairs that I literally ripped a piece of skin off of my lip. And that was it. Decided, forget it. I'll just go back to using the little Nair face thing that I was using before. It was so red. It hurt so bad. This might be a good body. I don't wax like my legs and stuff. I just shave. I don't do any of that extra arms. People that shave their arms or wax arms, I don't do any of that. So at least it was $3.99, right? Okay, so let's get to the next thing. I have quite a few more favorites. The NYX, these are the setting sprays. I did get both of them, the matte finish and the dewy finish, and I love these. I always find myself currently coming more to the dewy finish, but it really depends. I judge how I want to use it depending on how my face came out. If my face makeup looked too matte after I put my powder and my blush and everything on, like today it's just right. But if it looked too matte, I would go ahead and use the dewy. Okay, and just give it a couple of spritzes on your face, and I really feel like it keeps my makeup on for longer, and it's just refreshing. And I think these are $7.99. If you get them just right at Ulta, you could buy one, get one half off. And then the matte I would use if my face looked too dewy and too moist. So I really do like these. I recommend them. What the heck? I recommend them. I do have the Maron Barrier Spray, which is like the professional for Broadway and professional makeup. I really love. I feel that's definitely got a better staying power, but these are great for everyday use. Absolutely love this product. All right, the next product that I really love is the, and it's been around for a while, I just never tried it because I had so many other different kinds, and this is the Arganics Argan Oil by NUME. This little thing here, $50 on their website. Absolutely love this product. I fill up my little sample, so I keep this one in storage and I leave this one on my vanity. I use it every single time I get out of the shower. I comb through my hair and I apply it on, and it makes my hair feel super soft. It dries pretty quickly considering I have such thick hair, and I just love it. It's worth every penny. One of my next things that I absolutely love, and I've repurchased this quite a few times, this is a color correcting perfection primer illuminator, and this is made by Fisk Industries, Bioris, Rene, Descartes. I don't know the name of this, but I bought this at Sally Beauty Supply for $4.99. This is a face primer, and I absolutely love it. I've repurchased it over and over again. It has like a very, it's the same color as the tube, if you can see it, but it's just rubs out clear and perfectly and just super, super smooth onto your skin, that it just covers up every pore. It feels very, very soft, and I mean, it doesn't feel wet at all. So I use this every single day over, I know this sounds funny, over my Olay when I feel like my face is really oily. So I use this as a primer, but if I feel like my face feels a little oily that day, I'll just dab a little bit of this in my oily spots. I love that. For $4.99 at Sally Beauty Supply, go check it out. All right, one of the next things that I really loved this month was my Tarte emphasEYES eyebrow mousse, Amazonian clay eyebrow mousse, and it came with this, the applicator. I've been using it on my eyebrows every single day. Obviously not today, I didn't fill them in. I absolutely love it. I picked the color Taupe, which in retrospect is a little reddish for me, but I know you guys can't tell, but I have like reddish hair. It's growing out, so you know, when I go back to coloring, well, I want to leave my hair its natural color, but because I found a couple of grays over here, I'm gonna dye it its natural color. Make sense? Dark brown. I'm gonna keep my hair like a dark brown, blackish color, because that's what my natural hair color is. I will have to get the darker eyebrow mousse, because this one is a little too red, but it works for right now. All right, the next thing that I really liked this month was the Rimmel London Kate lip glosses. These are matte. They're super, super pretty. I am loving color 113 and 101. Let's do... Okay, this is 113. Just a very light, nudie pink color. And 101. And they're matte. That's why I think I love them. This is a more of a pinky color. So this is Pinky Berry, sorry. But they are matte, and I love them. They have this, like, distinct fragrance about them that I really like. They're only a couple of dollars at drugstores, so check that out if you get a chance. All right, the next thing on my radar is the Tarte Amazonian... No, duh. Is the Tarte Eyelash Curler. Yeah, the Amazonian Clay one. Is the Tarte Eyelash Curler. I love this, buddy. It is just the way it works. It is just excellent. It's easy to clean. I love the grip. The other doing this is like, this is just automatic spring. And it gives you the little clip. So when you store it, you just put the little clip on it. Absolutely love it. And the set that I bought it on QVC, was the limited edition. So that's why it's just not purple. It's purple and pink. It came with the Lights, Camera, Lashes mascara. Love, 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 love this. I cannot wait to finish this so I could buy a full size. It is worth every penny. The brush is amazing. It has big bristles, little bristles, in between bristles, super thick. The formula is wonderful. It makes my lashes so va-va-voom. I absolutely love them. Great set. I'll leave the link down below if it's still on QVC. I think I got this for $16 when just the curler $16. If you get the limited edition set, $16 too. They may have it at Sephora as well. All right, and just a couple more quick flips, and then I'll talk about my last flop, and this video will be done. So a lot of people have talked about this Wet n Wild Reserve Your Cabana with it's a bronzer with SPF 15. Beautiful. It's just a very nice color. Some people use it for all over. It's just a really pretty shimmery color, and I actually see very, very light. Depending on everyone's skin tone, it works differently. I do have it on this look. It's just very lightly in my highlighting area. I absolutely love it. Just the formula is perfect, and this is only a couple of dollars itself. And actually, the expiration on this is it has a 1 year shelf life. So just remember that. This is good until 2014. Don't forget that your makeup does expire. One of the biggest things, all these people go and buy all this makeup and then gotta throw it all away, because I've had to do that on way too many occasions. All right, and then the last two things here. This Sinful Shine Nail Polish is beautiful. All right, these are exclusively at Walgreens. This is the new collection. I was introduced to this in my influencer, so I wanted to go buy more colors. They're $2.99 each. They're absolutely beautiful. I am wearing two of the colors on my nails. Sorry. All right. Ooh. Somebody's dropping. I am wearing two of the colors. I'm wearing Picante and Mardi Gras on my nails. This beautiful color here is Rendezvous. I went and I got about seven of them. So it has the gel tech technology. They're really shiny. You see the light catching them. They're really shiny, and then the color is just beautiful. So for $2.99, go to Walgreens and check those babies out. And my last flip is something that I need to do a follow-up video on, and I promise I am getting to it this week. It is the Rimmel London Lash Accelerator Growth Serum. Now, you've heard me talk about the Lash Accelerator Mascara, Endless Mascara, but before I was introduced to this, I went to Walgreens, and I think it was $7.99, I purchased this. I'm really trying to find something to help grow my eyebrows, and if I get up close, you will see there is a little bit of growth, so I do want to do a follow-up video on this product. I just think it's me, my hormones, like one side grows more than the other, I don't know. So this product I really, really liked. It was worth every penny of the $8 that I paid for it. I put it on both my eyelashes and my eyebrows every single night. I removed my makeup, washed my face before I went to bed, and then in the morning I would just take a baby wipe with a little bit of toner, remove it with makeup remover off of my eyelash, and get ready in the morning as usual. So it was really effortless. I didn't have to do anything special. I didn't worry about my eyes burning. I didn't have any bad side effects. I promise I will be doing a full review on this product. Just as a added bonus, because I forgot to include this on my list when I wrote my list out on this envelope, the NYX Butter Gloss, I'm wearing that on my lip. I love this. It's just really pretty. I bought a bunch of them. This one is in the color Merengue. I also have the Butter Gloss in Tiramisu, and I even went and tried the Soft Matte Lip Cream. I just really, really like these products. They're light. How do I want to say it? It's easy enough that I'm putting it on to be out in the daytime, where I don't look overdone. It's just enough. Simple, easy. It's great for, you know, work every day, outside events. This is a great product for a gift for teenager or tween. And the formula is just amazing. It's super creamy, super soft. It's not sticky. Not sticky at all. And it's a great product. And once again, you can get these at Ulta if you get the buy one, get one half off. And my final flop, and I'm sure you know what it is, was the Beauty Box 5 subscription. That was just, I had enough. I got one last final box, surprisingly, and I'm glad it's over with, because I actually had a couple of comments from people. One girl said she got like 4 things in the box. I watched her video and it's like they just gave her all of the crap leftovers. Horrible. In my opinion, no. Don't waste your $12. Put your $12 into something else. It was just not worth it for me. So, thank you for watching this June's Flips and Flops, and I will see you guys in our next video. As always, questions or comments, leave them down below, and I will talk to you guys later. Bye!